Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm Sakuems, I'm a French artist and YouTuber, and in this week's video I'm going to do another free marker challenge. So I have all my markers right here in this giant salad bowl because I just have a lot of markers, so I needed to have them in some sort of containers. And I will use the colorless blender if I have to, because this is just pure alcohol, it doesn't count as a colored or as a marker. Mix everything up and then I will pick some colors and I will color an artwork that I did. So I basically, I shared this on Instagram. I actually did this character first and I really love the concept. It's just so cute. She's really adorable and I just felt so bad of like making a free marker challenge with this. I don't want to ruin this with very odd colors. So I did another character from like in a sketch that I had on computer. This is just more simple for a free marker challenge, but I really wanted to do the artwork first so I'm not biased with the colors. So I will color that. I'm going to mix everything up and I will pick some colors. I really hope that we'll get a nice pick. So I'm gonna close my eyes and I'm just gonna do a little swirl and hope for the best. So I'm gonna get this, it's a sketch. I'm gonna try to grab a shadow as well. I'm gonna get this chow marker, and for the last one, okay, this one. Oh my god! Oh boy. So that's my pick. Oh god. This color is so light. You guys, this is a super pale color. This might as well be like a two marker challenge. I should have removed a very light shade, because it doesn't make any sense. It's the two marker challenge. I'm still gonna try to find a light shade or a very old shade. I guess it's kind of dangerous for me to do that because I can also just find something worse than YG triple, like 40, but I'm still gonna gamble on that and pick this. Oh boy. A B99. This is kind of good like for shading, but it's also very dark. But yeah, I guess this is what you get when you try to pick a new color. I mean, like, I would love to have a yellow. This would really work nice. But this is so pale that you can't even see it when you work with this. So I guess I'm gonna use those three. So I have then BD13, which is hydrangea blue. I have this RV09, which is a very fuchsia pink. Basically, it's called fuchsia. And my darker shade is B99. I can manage to make something, but it's going to be kind of hard. We're just gonna roll with that and see how this goes with this artwork. Hopefully this turned out kind of nice.
So the first thing that I've done on this artwork was using my Colorace with black pencil, just to add a bit of the shading and just to figure out where I will put my shadows. And I really wanted to have a clean, slightly sketchy drawing type of base, because I'm also scanning this for my Patreon rewards for this month. No, not for this month, for next month. So if you'd like to get this as a coloring, like a coloring sketchy type of artwork, we'll add that on my Patreon. Then I scanned this and I jumped straight into coloring. I didn't really plan as much as I should have, I think. It's like it's all colored, so I managed to at least do a lighter skin tone. But because my colors were super different in a way that I have, I see a very dark blue. I have a very bright pink that is also quite like a medium shade. It's not like a lighter pink, it's a very fuchsia pink. And then my in-between color, which is more lighter, was my BD13. It's like a lilac color. So I definitely use a lot of the blender. The first thing that I've done was, at first I wanted to do highlights on the hair, but I couldn't really manage that. So I just thought I could add the blender afterwards and kind of lift some of the colors. So I did a first pass with my fuchsia color on the entire hair, and then I switched to a nip-to-nip technique with my blender, basically wetting the surface on the skin and grabbing the colors directly from the nib of the marker and like very lightly dabbing it and swirling it. And if you want to know more about swirling and dabbing, I have a video, we'll link in the corner, which is my Copic tips. I've used a lot of those techniques to almost do it's like a pointillism technique for the skin. It was kind of hard to dissolve the BV13 into the white of the paper. So I did use a lot of blender, and at some point the paper was kind of warping a bit. But after drying, it's completely flat, so really happy with the paper. I'm using a Clairefontaine Poland. It's like it's supposed to be a cardstock, nothing really fancy with that. It does bleed a tiny bit, but not a lot more than most cardstocks, so I'm really happy with that. So I did use a tiny bit of the fuchsia with also this dabbing technique. I grabbed some of it and I added some contrast to the skin and trying to make it like a watercolor effect. I think you can notice that on the skin. But I didn't really expect her to look like a zombie or something. This is something kind of funny with the colors choices. It was actually, you will think because I had a blue, a pink and a light blue, was really easy, but it was very, very hard to blend those because the dark, it's like a blue, it's B99 is actually more of a darker turquoise color and it wasn't blending with the pink at all. I don't know why. They seem to be working together, but they were just too different. I think one is very saturated, the pink, and this, this dark turquoise is one of my favorite color, but it's also one of the darkest color Copic range has. And it made it kind of hard for me to do shading, but because Copic ink is translucent, I was able to still do different passes and come on top and then use the blender, etc., just to add highlights. But going back to the character, at first, this was inspired by a very famous portrait of an Afghan girl that has green eye and a very dark skin and dark hair. If I can find it, I will link the picture in the description below. And the character is completely different because she was supposed to be a Middle East type, not Middle East, I don't know exactly where she's supposed to be from. I think it's Afghanistan, but I'm not sure. But she has a very dark skin and dark hair, and she's nowhere near that in my artwork because I turned her into a alien zombie-like character, which is very interesting and kind of funny. I don't know, it gives a different edge. I was not expecting such colors on my artwork when I sketched that. Ultimately, like I said, because I had a different idea, I was wondering, like, what can I do? And I just, you know, used up a sketch that I plan on doing for a digital artwork for a tutorial, and I was like, you know what, this is already, I have the sketch done, I'm gonna use this idea. But at first I intended to be closer to the original and just do the regular color, but yeah, she turned out to be completely different from an otherworldly type of environment, and I actually really liked the outcome of this because the skin is very radiant and it really pops because I keep it quite light. And then I used the blue, the dark blue and the pink to shade the hair, and I also added some of the blender to add highlights. And for the outfit, I'm using mainly B99, and I did a few passes, and then I added some of the highlights with the blender and just a tiny bit of the pink to fuse it. And yeah, that's basically what I had to do on this artwork. So hope you enjoyed it. This is how it turned out. The last thing that I've done was adding some highlights with a white gel pen. Now, usually not a big fan of white highlights. I think they should just create too contrast. But for this artwork, it kind of worked because it really helps bringing it to life. And the coloring took about an hour, so not long, but it was kind of hard still. But I feel like I want to do more of those because I feel kind of lucky still because, yeah, it wasn't really that hard. So hoping to do another one of those videos in the future because I really want to get an odd peek, very odd peek. So if you'd like to see more of those challenges, then don't forget to comment below and tell me what you guys think about that. Also, yeah, I kind of changed one of the color. And I don't know if it was for the best or the worst because I think it misses some yellow, but yeah. So that's it. If you'd like to get this artwork, I will have it in my store because I really like how it turned out. And for next week, I think I'm going to color the other artwork that I had in mind for today because I really like her and it's already done, so I just have to color it. So it will be another Copic slash pencil artwork. And yeah, I think that's it. Thank you for watching, you guys. If you like the video, don't forget to thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more of my content, I post every weekend, so don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye, guys.